Fine. So write down the next topic, motional EMF. You had the charger, right? Type C. This Samsung Tab 2. Okay, so assume that you have a rod of length L, okay? Rod of length L moving with velocity V in a magnetic field which is into the board. Fine. This is the magnetic field. Can this rod develop an EMF, a potential difference? Yes or no? Is there any change in flux over here? Is there any change in flux? Yes or no?
There is no loop.
There is no question of flux. Okay? But still it has an EMF. Will it have a current? Current needs a loop.
Yeah.
There will not be any current, but there will be EMF. EMF don't need a loop. It's like a battery moving. Fine. You need to find out how much is the EMF, as in what is the potential difference between this end, let's call it as 1, and this as 2. Between 1 and 2, what is the potential difference? Okay, but before you do that, first tell me, will there be charge accumulation at one of the end? Like, will there be a will the electron will move towards 1 or 2? Where it will go? Electrons inside the metals, they are free to move, right? So if they experience a force upward, they'll move upwards. Mm-hmm. If they experience a force downward, they'll move downwards. Where they'll move? Upwards, negative charge. How? V cross B on a positive charge. Downward force. On negative, it will be upward. So upward, there will be accumulation of electrons. Fine. So electrons will accumulate there, and of course, lack of electrons here, so there will be positive charge. Fine. So it's like a charge separation. So there will be potential difference between these two points. Fine. The electrons will keep on accumulating here till when? Will they keep on accumulating? Till whatever time this is moving, or it will stop accumulating after some time. Can it accumulate infinite amount of charge just by this? Why?
Because finite
charge. Magnetic force is in which direction for the electron? That way. This is the magnetic force direction. Mm-hmm. Is there any other force on the electron? Any other force on the electron? These positive charges, won't it pull it down? So there will be electric force. Isn't it? When magnetic force in magnitude becomes equal to electric force, charges will stop accumulating.
None of the markers. These three doesn't work.
So when magnetic force become equal to electric force, okay? Magnetic force is how much? Let's say E is the charge on the electron. E, velocity is perpendicular to B. V cross B is just V into B. And suppose electric field is E. Electric field is E, upward direction. The force in downward direction for the negative charge will be E into electric field. So now, so electric field become what? Equals to B into V. Fine. And EMF is what? EMF is integral of E dot dl, negative of that. You remember this? So when you do that, electric field is downward direction, you're also moving down, so dot product becomes 1. So this just becomes BV into L and minus sign. Minus sign because you are finding this potential minus that potential. Okay? But if you just consider magnitude of EMF, it will be BLV or BVL, whatever. Fine? So if a rod moves in a magnetic field, fine? If a rod moves in a magnetic field, its velocity is perpendicular to magnetic field and perpendicular to the length. So basically B, V and L, all three are mutually perpendicular to each other. If that is the case, then EMF is BVL. And if that is not the case, then suppose the rod is like this and velocity is like that. This is theta. Length is L, magnetic field is B. Then what is the EMF now between these two ends? Then take the velocity that is perpendicular component, V sin theta. Fine? So EMF is B L V sin theta. Simple? Fine? So you have to take velocity that is perpendicular to the length. Any doubt on this? Okay. Let's analyze a situation. Suppose you have rails. Resistance is R over here. Okay, this is a rail. Draw this. This length is L. Fine. Magnetic field is into the board. Go out. Magnetic field is B. You have, suppose, a rod like this. Okay? Rod is moving with velocity V. Okay? Rod is moving with velocity V. V is constant. Fine. You have to find out what is the EMF, current and force required to move this rod with constant velocity.
So what are these lines?
These are conductor only. These two are conductor connected with a resistance like this. Like a U-shaped one. This rod is sliding on it. These are required to make sure the loop is completed all the time.
Yeah. again force.
Tell me, how will you find EMF? Will EMF be BLV? It will be BLV only. BLV only, right? But this is a loop also. So you will get ideas that why can't we find using flux? Fine? Let us try to see whether that if we find using flux, will that come out to be same? Okay? So let us assume this to be X. This X keeps on changing, right? As it slides forward. So area is what? Area of the loop is? X into L. So flux throughout is D into X into L. Right? So D5 by DT is what? B into L is constant. So BL DX by DT. What is DX by DT? Velocity. So you get BLV only. If you find using flux, same thing you will get. Fine. So EMF is BLV. How much is the current? BLV by R. Now, in order for this to move with constant velocity, what should happen? Net force on this should be zero. Acceleration should be zero. Right? Now, if it is trying to move, is there a magnetic force on this rod or not? With direction. When I ask such question, you don't have to think twice before saying that it will be on the left hand side. Why? Because of Lenz's law. It will oppose the cause. Fine. Keep it very simple. So if it is moving like this, force has to be backward direction. The cause is the change in flux that is increasing. It should oppose that. So magnetic force will be backside. How much is this value? Magnetic force. FB is what? How will you find? There is a wire which has a current in a magnetic field. So ILB, IL into B, everything is perpendicular to each other, IL and B. So this will be what? Simply B square L square V by R. This is force. Okay? Any doubt? No. Now this is a magnetic force. What it will do? It will try to decelerate the velocity. Velocity will decrease. You have to make sure the velocity doesn't decrease. What you have to do? You have to apply a pull here, which is equal to this. Then only the net force becomes zero. So this is your force. So how much force you should apply? Equal in magnitude, but in opposite direction. Right? How much power you have to supply? Power is what? Power supplied by a force is force into velocity. Okay? This is force into velocity becomes what? B square L square V square by R. This is the power which you are supplying. Or this is the rate of work which you are doing. Okay, where this goes?
Where it goes?
Just check what is I square R. How much is this? Put the value of I here. You will get the same thing. B square V L square V by R. So whatever power you supply is lost as a heat in the resistance. Okay, so you can see the energy conservation is
valid in this scenario. Any doubt?
Anything? No?
Okay.
Should I proceed?
We'll do one numerical on motional EMF.
Suppose you have a rod. This rod can rotate about this axis. Fine. This rod is rotating with angular velocity omega. The length of the rod is L. Fine. The magnetic field is coming out everywhere. Magnetic field is uniform, B. Fine. You need to find potential difference between point 1 and 2. This is a rod moving with velocity, so it will induce motional EMF or not, right? But is the entire rod moving in the same velocity? No. Every point on the rod moves with a different velocity. Okay. So assume a dr width. I can assume this dr is moving with the same velocity. Suppose this distance is r. What is the velocity? Omega into r. I can say this dr is moving with omega into r velocity. So the EMF developed across dr is what? Let's say that is dE. Will be what? Dr length moving with omega r velocity. So small EMF across dr will be dLv, right? L is what? Dr. So it will be what? B. L is dr into v, which is omega r. Fine. This is EMF across dr. So in order to find the total EMF, I should integrate 0 to e, and this goes from 0 to capital R. Total length. So EMF will come out to be what? Half b omega r square. You have to remember this. This is like the usual that comes up. Any doubt? Fine, we'll do the last question and then we'll leave for today. Should I dictate the question now? The question goes like this. There is this rod, let's say this is PQ, okay? This PQ starts from here, where x equal to 0. Magnetic field is from x equal to 0 till x equal to b only. From x equal to b to x equal to 2b, there is no magnetic field, alright? So this rod moves with constant velocity v, alright? It starts from x equal to 0, goes till x equal to 2b, then comes back and again reaches x equal to 0 with the same magnitude of speed. Getting it? Right?
So it goes and comes back.
Yeah, it goes with the velocity v, comes back. Same magnitude of velocity. Alright? Now, in this entire process, you have to observe these things and plot the graph. This is flux with time, no, not time, x. Flux with x, this is EMF with x, this is force required to move this with constant velocity with x, and this is power delivered with x. Okay, of course it will cross x equal to a, so you can draw a line like this. This line represents x equal to a. Alright? Then it will go to x equal to 2b. So this line represents x equal to 2b. After this, what will happen? It will come back. So what I will do is that I will draw x equal to a further ahead. So this is x equal to a. Then what will happen? Then again x will become equal to 0. Fine, so this line is x equal to 0. So this is x equal to a, x equal to 2a, x equal to b, right? X equal to b, x equal to 2b, again x equal to b, and then x equal to 0. Plot these graphs. What will happen to flux? Flux will increase or not?
Increase.
X equal to 0. The loop's area is increasing?
Increase and decrease.
Right?
Right.
Once this rod goes beyond x equal to b, will the flux increase?
No.
Number of field lines will not increase. It will still remain that only because magnetic field ceases to exist after x equal to b. So flux will become constant, right? So flux will rise like this, it will go like that, and then it becomes constant till it comes back to x equal to b. And then what will happen?
Decrease.
Flux will decrease. Right? What about EMF? EMF is what? Rate of change of flux. The rate of change of flux is positive right now. So EMF will be negative using sign convention. Okay? And that is constant till flux is changing with constant rate. Getting it? After that, what will happen?
Zero.
Zero. The flux doesn't change. So EMF will be zero. It will be like this. And then the maximum value or this value will be equal to what? BLV. Okay. The maximum flux will be equal to what? This value equal to B into this is suppose L. B L into small b. Isn't it? Now what about force? Force is B square L square V by R. When the flux is increasing, you need to apply force like that. And when flux is decreasing, you need to push it. So force is changing the direction, right? So it is basically in the direction of the velocity. Velocity direction is same, okay, till x equal to b. After x equal to b, anyway, current is not there, so there is no force. You don't need to apply any force after that. So basically, you need to apply force like that, like this, then no force, okay, goes like this, then you have to push it down, push it back. This is force. You need to apply force like this or not?
Yes, sir.
So I'm plotting this force, what you are applying.
Negative
as in when it comes back here, then magnetic force will be in which direction? Magnetic force will be this direction, and then you have to push like this. So your direction of force is changing. Fine. What about power? Power is force into velocity. So power becomes this square. So now it is velocity square. It will not change the sign. Power remains positive throughout. Like this. Even negative will become positive. Fine. So this is how you have to do this particular question. Fine. So still few things are left in this chapter. There is inductance that is left, and you have to practice many, many questions at home. Minimum 50 questions if you are serious about mains. Minimum. That's like just eligible to write JEE. Okay. Fine, so come up with your doubts and then we'll...
Sir,
sir. I have to tell you the fees now.
Sir, sir, for the sleep it's those 47 or the magnetism.
Magnetism also 50, and this also 50. You have to really slog it out, man. It's not a joke. 150 chapters in 5 months. It's tough. And let me tell you, this is the better chance for you, like January 1. Because when you write in April, those guys who are studying in Kota, they'll get 3 times more time than you. While you are busy with pre-boards and boards, preparation with that, they get more time. So they will get ahead from you between Jan and April frame of mind. So if you do well in January, which is same for everyone, the difficulty you are facing, they are also facing. So January gives you a better chance to get ahead of them. Otherwise, by the time April comes, they will be, probably will be, you know, they have more time, so they can get ahead more. So make sure you treat January as your final attempt for mains. You're coming for physics and maths.